But I think there's a role that we play.
Elsa, I believe Ukraine going to be the same phenomenon as Romania now is. Romania is well known all over the world, the country fighting against corruption on non-stop basis. So they continue investigations, they start investigation, they imprison officials, not only former but current one, and it will make Ukraine famous in a few years. And regarding people-to-people exchange, I see there is our friends from Germany, Marie-Louise Beck, and of course she was a witness of the process when Berlin became a star on the map of Europe. And Ukraine is the same. Berlin was, at that time in the 90s, it was the slogan, Berlin is poor but sexy. Ukraine is the same. Ukraine is poor, it's true, but Ukraine is sexy. It's a vibrant country with new generation of people who are ready to take responsibility for the country, with completely new modern art, modern culture, modern music, modern contemporary art. So this is the country to be, and this is a destination to be in boring Europe. Believe me, if you compare some countries in Europe, Ukraine made huge step forward. I know this because I'm traveling a lot and I have knowledge to compare. Yeah. In this sense, what we have to do? We have to make Ukraine famous in Europe as a destination to be and to demonstrate our European friends that we are the same, we share the same values, we are the same educated, and we can speak on the same language. In this sense, I believe Ukraine is a brilliant destination.
I see a future for you, Sahi, in brand management and public relations. The Ukraine slogan around the world is going to be what? Relatively poor, but very sexy.
It's not bad. It's not bad.
And you're going to work on the poor bit, obviously. The sexy bit you can live with for a while.
But sexy in positive sense, not in the gender sense, but in sense.
Oh, no, I know. All right, last